Hi everyone, I'm Sharon Smith, and today I'm going to show you how to automate formatting and combine multiple sheets in Excel using Power Query. Once you set this up, it's going to save you so much time because it's going to allow you to streamline your data cleanup workflow. Then all you have to do is click refresh to add a new workbook into your master spreadsheet. Then you can analyze your cumulative data in pivot tables. Let's take a look. In this example here, I have a shared file folder where I have a report that is scheduled to run monthly. It comes out here and it's a 401k report. So just going to open this up so you can take a look at this. It's an employee listing report that gets automatically run, and it contains information about the pay date, so the month ending pay date, and it has everyone's 401k election, but it has a lot of extra columns, and it doesn't include our 401k deferral calculation, which we need to add into the spreadsheet. So each month, instead of formatting this report and adding the columns that are needed and deleting the ones that we don't need, all we have to do is set this up in Power Query to transform the data. And then we're going to combine the sheets. And then every time a new workbook gets added to the file folder, then all of our data changes, our formatting will automatically apply, and it will add onto a master spreadsheet that we can then use a pivot table to analyze the data. So let's take a look and see how this works. So I'm going to go ahead and close out of this spreadsheet here. And we're going to go ahead and open up just a new blank workbook. So if you have a blank workbook open, you can just use that. And then what we want to do is come up to data and then click on Get Data. We're going to hover over From File, and you can see all these different ways that we can get data into Excel and using Power Query, the user interface. And so we're going to say From Folder, since we have a shared folder that we want to pull any report that gets saved out there. So we're going to say From Folder, and then we're going to navigate and select the folder that we want to map to. And then we're going to click Open, and this will establish a connection to that file folder. And here we can see our two files that are out there. We're going to go ahead and come down here, and we have different options. We can simply load the data to an Excel table. We can transform the data, which will open up the Power Query user interface. But because we want to set this up so that any new file that we add to that folder will be added as soon as we refresh the data, what we're going to do is select Combine, and then we're going to select the top option, which is Combine and Transform Data. Then what we can do is it's always going to look at the first file, which is totally fine. If you needed to look at a different file, you can select that up here, but the first file is fine. We're going to select our tab here from our file, and then you'll notice that the data loads over here on the right in a little preview, and then we're just going to click on OK. Now the Power Query user interface, the editor, opens up, and here is where we can do all of our formatting and transforming our data. And so if you have a very large data set, so a very large spreadsheet that may have more than 1,000 rows, it's only going to display the first 1,000 rows, but then when you close and load, it will load the entire data set and apply your changes. This spreadsheet isn't that big, but what we're going to do is go ahead and start our formatting. So we don't need the source name column, so all we have to do is right click and remove that. Now notice over here on the right, there is a window called Applied Steps under the Query Settings, and this is going to record all of the actions that you take on the spreadsheet. So you only have to do this once, and like I said, it will automatically apply all of the changes that you make to future spreadsheets that you drop into that file folder. So over here, what we want to do is we want to go through our spreadsheet and delete the columns that we don't need. And so all we have to do is select our extra columns. So I'm going to go over, and we have quite a few extra columns that we don't need in our spreadsheet. So I'm just going to select one and hit Control and select all the other columns that we want to remove from our spreadsheet. And I'm going to right click and say Remove Columns. Now over here, it just says removed columns, but it will track exactly which columns were removed and remove those same columns from other spreadsheets. Now we have the 401k election here, And we have our annual salary over here. Let's just go ahead and drag our election over next to the annual salary. So all you have to do is drag and drop the column where you want it. It will record that action as moving that column. And then this is the data type over here. If you click on the icon next to the column header, you can update that. So for annual salary, if we want that to be a currency, we just have to select that as a data type. The 401k election is actually a percentage, so we can select that as the data type there. And then what we want to do is actually add a column that's going to be the 401k deferral amount, and that's going to be calculated based on the annual salary and the 401k election. And so what we want to do there is come up to add column, and we're going to click on a custom column. And here's where we can enter in what we want to do. And what we want to do is we want to take the annual salary. So I'm going to select the field over here for annual salary, click on insert, and then I'm going to say divided by 26, and then we're going to say times, and we want to multiply that by the 401k election, and we'll click that field and hit insert, and then we'll click OK. And this adds a column at the end of the sheet that has our new custom amount. And so we can double click to update the title. We're going to call this 401k deferral amount. And hit enter. And now we can drag that over next to the 401k election. Then we can change the data type to currency. And then this gives us the amount that we want to capture on our spreadsheet. Now, once you're done with all of your data transformations, when you're ready to load the data back into an Excel spreadsheet, all you have to do is go back to the Home tab and click on Close and Load, and we're going to Close and Load. And this is going to load. Notice that it loaded both spreadsheets. So if we come over to the column of data that has our pay date, notice that we have both the January and the February reports out here that have been combined and loaded in. And both of them are displaying our new 401k deferral amount. And we have conveniently restructured our spreadsheet and formatted it the way that we want it. So now, when we drop our new report, or our new report automatically gets saved out onto that shared folder, let's go ahead and do that. We're going to go back out to our shared folder, and let's add the March data out here. I'm just going to copy and paste the March data out onto our shared folder. So now we have our March report out onto the mapped shared folder. I'm going to minimize that. And then all we have to do is come up to our table design here out in the query and click on refresh. Now, if I scroll over, notice our pay date now includes all of the March data as well. And notice that all of the formatting that we applied gets automatically applied to that March report, and it gets plugged in here. So now that we have all of our combined data saved into one place, we can save this, we can automatically save our file, and then we can do some data analysis. We can create a pivot table and look at our data that way. So for example, if we want to create a pivot table that will show us our total deferral amounts, we can do that. All we have to do is come up to Insert, go to Pivot Table, from the Pivot Table range, we'll say on a new worksheet, we'll click OK. And then all we have to do is drag, let's say we want to have our pay date. And let's just say we just want the pay date, so we can remove this, the extra fields here. And then we want to see our 401k deferral amount. And we want this to display as a currency. And now we have our pivot table with our data, and we can actually insert a chart here as well. Just come up to Insert, and then we can pick a chart. And now we have our chart type here that we can edit and modify in case we need to report out on this data. We can see any trends where people's deferral elections might have gone up or down. So maybe we had a marketing campaign and people's deferrals went up. We can track that data here. I hope this example gave you some ideas on how you can use Power Query to streamline your data cleanup. If you found this video helpful, be sure and give it a thumbs up to like it and share it with all your colleagues and friends. You can subscribe to my channel and click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. Don't forget to visit my my website, SharonSmithHR.com, for more tools and resources. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.